I think all Fairhaveners have a little magic in them. Even the non-witches. They ooze something unique.
Ah, right on time. Here's enough medicine for everyone in town. One dose each should heal them up just fine. And don't forget to drink your vial, Tara. I've already taken mine.
Will do.
Hey, Sophia.
What's new?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Ugh, I'm so bored with my menu, I could cry.
Wow, why don't you add some new recipes?
Oh, do you have any ideas? Did you inherit Hazel's gift in the kitchen?
Nope, not me. I didn't inherit anything.
Oh, well, that's too bad. Well, if you do have any food items you want to sell, let me know. I'll buy it if I can sell it in the cafe. At least then there'll be some variety.
Tara! You absolute treasure. Thank you.
This year, I'd like to focus more on listening and learning than judging.
You say that every year.
Only because it's true.
Ah, my medicine manifestation has paid off. I appreciate the help, Tara.
Plants will always tell you what they need. My grandmother said they'd sing to her, and I believe it.
Thanks for running this all the way over here, Tara.
It feels Angus-level corny to say out loud, but after learning about all this magic business, I'm trying to be romantic in a new way. Like, apparently Lena had been practicing some time-pausing spell back when we met, so naturally I had to hit her with the, "Is that why it felt like time stopped when I first saw you?"
Oh, cute! But you're right. That was a lot of corn. A whole earful.
Oh, retaliatory pun. Nice.
Whew. I do appreciate this.
Thanks, Tara. I can't wait to feel hashtag better. My followers probably missed me.
These boots were supposedly waterproof, but the cows dumped over their trough today and, well, they're not waterproof.
Truly appreciate it, Tara. You can tell Yuri spent a lot of time with her elders. She knows to stop by and look out for us oldsters. You do too.
Thank you. Thanks, Tara.
Giva says math and music are friends. To me, they're frenemies.
Thanks, Tara. I was getting so tired of feeling tired.
I wonder if Kai will sell me a discounted apple tree next time he has one in stock. I'm thinking about breaking into the apple cider market, but Mom's not gonna let me buy all her apples at wholesale.
Ooh, I cannot wait to be decongested. Thank you, Tara.
Not that I'm not having fun, but is it too soon to wish for summer to come around?
I don't know if I should say yuck or yay. I never thought I'd be so excited to take medicine.
Man, I wish there was a spell for getting your homework done. Wait, is there a spell for getting your homework done?
Yes, dual nostril breathing. I've missed you so.
I did not need to know that Yuri was working Fashion Week while I had to scroll pics to Twit for updates. She's so lucky. Like, someone take me to Milan.
Thank goodness. Thank you, Tara.
Antonio's been asking for us to come visit him, but I'm not sure if that's a good idea. Things feel so fragile right now.
Oh, thanks for heeding my pies for help, Tara.
What is it like living in all that open space?
To tell you the truth, it is a lot of work.
Well, what a great way to work off delicious baked goods.
Merci beaucoup, sugar. I was getting sick and tired of shivering. Your kitten is such a sweet little thing. Reminds me of all the mouses in the French Quarter, baby. Especially when she followed me around because I got a dish of seafood.
There's my model.
Who? Me?
Of course. Try this one on for me.
Ooh, shiny.
Ay, que lindo. You're a vision.
Well, shucks.
But listen. I've got so many design ideas, but only two hands, right? If you make any of these at your jewelry table, I'd be delighted to buy the finished pieces. Or you could just bling yourself out, too. This island was a popular port for pirates and smugglers back in the day. I bet there's at least one sunken ship under those waves, just full of golden gems. Finally. Thanks, Tara. You're a star.
Listen to that purr.
Ah, fresh from the cauldron. Thank you, Tara.
Had I known how many questions I'd get about being a witch, I might have been Team Masks and Secrecy right along with you.
Ha! Too late now.
Ravenwood's home. But I gotta say, it'd be fun to visit the big city one day.
By big city, do you mean Milkwater?
I was thinking more like New York. I'd love to live in a place that never went to sleep.
Ah, the medicine is ready. Wonderful. Thank you, Tara.
Shelby's a tough nut to crack. He hardly mentions the past, but I can sense he's led a unique life. Our elders live on through their stories, so I'm going to keep trying.
Why Zephyr insists on spending so much time around humans mystifies me. Very few of you are that interesting.
I live here, but I'm home when I'm in the wilderness surrounded by my creature friends.
Thanks, Tara. You're a lifesaver. Kai's hair is always perfect. He's given me some great tips, but these girls just won't be tamed.
Boy, was I waiting on this. Thanks, Tara.
How'd the gifts go over with Jenny?
Better than I could have hoped. She adored him. Said the love card was just a literary delight. I love the way she speaks.
That's great. I guess that means dates in the future?
Sure does. And of course, more letters for when I can't go over to visit.
Sweet sinus relief, here I come. I owe you one, Tara.
Kai's always trying to convince me to join him out on the waves. I enjoy the craft, but it's not really my thing.
Thanks, Tara. You and Dr. Syed are awesome for this. Thomas being all loved up with Sophia is so weird. It's good, but I kind of feel bad for Juliet.
Good looking up, Tara. If Juliet's hanging out here and Sebastian comes in, she turns red and hides behind the counter.
That's very observant of you.
People think I don't notice stuff, but I'll have you know that I notice a lot.
Kim, I love your boots.
Oh, thanks. I've had these old stompers forever. I stole them from my big brother. Medicine and a delivery? Ugh, you're like a personal dose dash. Thanks, Tara.
Thank you for practically being on call for this, Tara. I couldn't have done it without you. Please, take this.
Yoru is a good kitty.
You still liked that, didn't you, kitty? How long should I soak for? Hey, Miney. It's off to work you go.
Sebastian certainly takes after Gloria and Violet when it comes to juggling the coven and his day-to-day. Seems like he bounces between Kai's stall and online classes more often than not nowadays.
So, when there's no giant all-hands-on-deck threat, do we ever kick back and, I don't know, throw a potluck?
Not really. Though if you think about it, the Wellspring itself is kind of like one big magical perpetual potluck.
I'm looking forward to learning magic without the stress of some looming threat or impending disaster, you know? I am not a lump of coal. I don't need that much pressure.
Now, I'm aces with drams and tonics and elixirs, but my ingredients have to already be foraged. I do not have an eye for figuring out which mushrooms are edible or Datura versus moonflowers.
Vi's cat is always leaving presents on the whelk. That's not something I...
Sometimes I visit the Coven Circle during the daytime. Have a look around.
Why do you do that, Parseer?
Because I want to. Simple as that.
Stands to reason.
I sprinkled some cinnamon on our doorstep for a night, and the kids were quick to trail it through the house. On the bright side, the carpet smells like snickerdoodles.
You would think I wouldn't appreciate trees so much after being encased in one for so long. It's so lovely to...
Okay, I'll need at least one shrink potion and one stretching potion before I can re-enter the phase circle.
Is it time for bed?